Tell you ain't got your questions ready.
Weddy. I like this one. I asked the question, ask any questions about gym, life, or school. Shout out to you, Esther underscore MS underscore pause guy. She just goes, life.
So let's talk about life.
Let's talk about life.
How is your day today?
Let's not talk about life. Also, shout out to JMiran66. What are your favorite socks?
Fuzzy.
I like how you had an answer right away.
And fuzzy, like, and the ones that have lotion. Have you seen those? Not in. No, stop. 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 No, stop. Why are you guys acting like this? You've never seen those before. If you have ever been to Bath and Body Works or whatever, they sell socks and they, and like in the fabric, it's not like actual lotion. It like moisturizes your feet.
All I gotta say is I have sweaty feet. We do not need to mix lotion and sweaty feet. That is,
and I remember they're actual socks though. Like they're not what you both just imagined.
Well, my favorite types of socks are normal socks.
Not even fuzzy?
No.
That's so boring.
Because I would say my favorite socks are just like nice patterned high socks.
Ugh. Okay.
I'm sorry, I'm a boring person.
Next question.
Iris.7n asks, why did you decide to go to UCLA?
The reason why I chose UCLA, well, because I first visited the school when I was 12. So first the food sold me. So the dining hall food, just so good. I loved the campus. I loved the LA area because the weather's really good. There's always something to do. So that intrigued me. I think we're still the number one public university. So the education that I was going to receive was going to be, you know, top tier. And I want to do broadcasting. So I felt that living in LA, going to UCLA, you know, and that would just be the perfect fit for me for like school-wise. And then the gymnastics team obviously sold me too, because getting to know the girls, I just love the culture too. And it was very diverse as well, the team.
Yeah.
This question is from Lila Luan underscore Lau. And she asked, what's the biggest challenge adjusting to post-college life?
Ooh, I'm still figuring it out, friends. I think the biggest adjustment post-college is honestly not being with your friends all the time. I would say it's a lot more lonely.
Yeah.
Okay, no, the reason why I say this is because you see your friends all the time. You see your teammates all the time. Post-college life, like, you're on your own.
And so everyone separates.
And everyone separates. People go back home. Yeah. People have jobs. It's really hard to get together now. So the biggest thing adjusting is trying to balance everything with like work, you know, keeping my soul alive. So I have lots of game nights at my house to try and get everyone together once in a while. So that really fuels my soul when I'm in a very work mode. Adjusting is kind of figuring, it's a lot of self-reflecting on what you need to be happy. I would say it's hard just because
it is very
college you're on a schedule, and now like I'm creating my own schedule.
Right, because I feel in college you learn a lot about yourself and
you learn more.
You mature a lot, but
yeah.
Then post-college,
you apply it
and you learn even more. You know what I mean? So it just, I feel that we're just constantly evolving and changing.
And I think just staying open to it is definitely the biggest thing post-college, is being open to opportunities, because you never know what door it's going to open.